With the introduction of iPadOS 14, Apple bought some much-needed tweaks to enhance user experience. Let's see how well they're running on this 3-year-old iPad Pro. First, let's talk about widgets. Instead of just having the standard widget, there's this feature called Stacks, where you can add multiple widgets into a stack and browse through different widgets. By default, the widget keeps rotating depending upon your usage. But you can turn on or off auto widget rotate. This is a very unique approach from Apple, and with more apps bringing their own spin on widgets, I'm sure the experience is going to be even better. The clock widget, which was debuted with beta 3, turns dark after evening and turns white during day, which is really nice. App suggestions widget is a must. Overall, I like the changes to widgets, but I do not like the fact that they just restricted to the side, which is just a waste of that huge screen real estate. Next, we can also switch between multiple tasks for the multi-window view, which is really cool. I'm sure there will be people out there who will definitely appreciate this feature. Calls now do not interrupt the entire screen, and it even stays in the corner if we swipe it away. We can always swipe down and bring back the familiar full screen interface. Navigating between app pages just got a lot easier now. Just swipe through different pages by swiping on the dotted line and you can just breeze through them. It's subtle tweaks like this that enhances user experience. Siri interface now is non-intrusive, but it is not so interactive. Previously, you were able to edit text, but now it isn't possible. This is important because Siri's voice recognition isn't that great, especially for Indian accents, so now we have to rely on it recognizing what we said accurately. Next, they've improved search interface, but some search results are weird, like the images look small, there's autofill like Google search, tap and you'll be taken to that result, there's also automatic web search suggestions with one tap. Again, this is all about simplifying the end user experience. Now you get a side view in default apps, which makes it easier to navigate. Next, pinned notes are now collapsible, which makes it easier to differentiate between the notes that are pinned and the ones that are not pinned. Now options are at the top, which is better than at the bottom, because previously as you start typing, the keyboard used to cover up these options like checklist, markup and others. Since they're moved to the top, it is much easier to access them. Now it is much easier to edit text, as we can precisely select the area that you want to edit. This is a much needed feature. Next, moving to Safari, it now shows logos on the tabs, which makes it easier to navigate between different tabs. They've also introduced privacy report, so now you can exactly see what data is being collected by which website, which gives us a better understanding. In beta 3, the music app icon is updated. Previously it used to be white, but now it's pink. But more importantly, the music app now remembers the progress of the song exactly where you left off, and it's about time we have this feature. We can also drag and drop a song into a playlist, which makes organizing songs a lot easier. Apple has introduced some privacy features which are absolutely top draw. Whenever the camera or microphone is being accessed, you'll be notified with either a green or orange circle. Green indicating that your camera is being accessed and orange indicating that your microphone is being accessed. And going to Control Center shows which app used either camera or the microphone, which alerts us and helps us understand better. Clipboard access is shown as a split second notification, which is great. A lot of apps have been exposed. I mean, some apps are accessing clipboard immediately after just opening them, which just shows how desperate they are. There are some features that for some reason Apple chose not to implement on the iPad, but on iPhone these work great. Features like removing home screen pages, alphabetical app search, and automatic app grouping by category. These things could have been really nice on the iPad, so I hope they'll bring them in the future. Now, if you own an iPhone 6s and want to see how stable iOS 14 on it is, then click here and I'll see you in that video.